Good morning. So some students said that they were not able to see this mid chat clearly. See on videos, you won't be able to see this mid chat very clearly. What you can do is you can have a mid chat with you. If you are not able to have a hard copy, you can always search on Google for mid chat PDF, and from there you can refer what I am doing. Okay. So I'll just say in 5 6 minutes what we had done yesterday. So we had this point as P1, this left extreme as P2, this right extreme as P3, and we had this point as P4. We had to identify the impedances of these points. Right? So what was P1? It is exactly at the center of the smith chart. If you observe at the center, 1.0 is written. So it indicates it is a constant resistance circle. Yesterday we discussed constant resistances and constant reactance circles. Again, I'll show what are those. So this is which circle? This is my R equal to 1 circle, which is passing through the center of the smith chart. This is what R equal to 1 circle. Resistance is 1. So as you move towards left, the resistance goes on decreasing. So here you encounter R equal to what? 0. And as you move towards right, it goes on increasing 10, 20, 50. So at this extreme, it is what R equal to infinity. So resistance is 0 here. So this indicates what? Short circuit. Resistance is infinite here. So this indicates what? Open circuit, since no current can flow in an infinite resistance circuit. Right? So you should know this point, that the left extreme is short circuit, right extreme is open circuit. And above part is what? Before that, we'll see what is constant reactance circle. If I extend this circle, it is what? This is what J 1 point, this is 1.0. So this is reactance R plus JX. So X equal to 1 circle. So JX equal to J 1 circle. We say R plus JX, so that J. If you want, for the time being, we can write X equal to 1. So this indicates what? Reactance. This indicates resistance. This indicates reactance. Like this, you can have this reactance also. This reactance here is 2. So this is X equal to 2 reactance circle. But if I draw the reactance circle here, let's say I take this one. This is again X equal to 1. But since it is downside, this is X equal to minus 1. So the reactance is negative here. Since reactance is negative, the lower half of smith chart is capacitive and upper half is inductive, since this reactance is positive. Okay, so these things you should know. So these are constant reactance circles. These are constant resistance circles. If you want, I can draw one more. This is again a constant resistance circle. R equal to 2. This is R equal to 2. So again, let's come back here. So we come here. So this is at center of this smith chart. We already saw center passes through R equal to 1 circle. So P1 represents re So it is an impedance smith chart. So we'll get R plus JX. Resistance is how much? 1. So if you observe this is J X equal to 1 circle. This is X equal to minus 1 circle. So this should be X equal to 0. So this is 1 plus J 0 point. So center of the smith chart is always 1 plus J 0 point, and it is called as matched point. ZL equal to Z0 we want, according to maximum power transfer theorem we discussed yesterday. So we are always concerned with this point. So this is a very important point for matching. Next, P2. We saw this is what? Short circuit. This is what? Open circuit. Right? P4. So if you go like this, so it indicates R equal to 1. So for P4, it is 1 and J is what? 1. So 1 plus J1. P4 is 1 plus J1. Similarly, you can find any other point arbitrarily. If I take this point, what is this? This is 1 and this is also J1, but it is downside, so it is 1 minus J1 point. Let's say this is P5. Right? So I hope it is clear now. Now, apart from this, there are two things you should know. We'll always have a circuit somewhat like this. We'll have a source separated. This is transmission line connected to a load impedance ZL. and this will have a characteristic impedance Z naught. What we'll do, we'll always normalize and plot. We'll plot ZL bar, ZL by Z naught. Why? Because we always plot normalized impedances only on the Smith chart. Right? So ZL by Z0 we'll plot. We'll not plot the absolute value of ZL. We'll always plot ZL by Z0. Okay? Then this we have already seen. We are just revising. Then this is my load. This is my generator voltage. So this is my generator. If I am moving towards left, where am I moving? I am moving away from the load, means towards the generator. So in that sense, where we will move? Here it is written, wavelength towards generator. So we'll move in which direction? Clockwise. So if you are moving towards the load, you are moving where? Towards right. So you are moving away from the load. So obviously you will go other way around, anti-clockwise. So when you are moving away from the load, that is towards the generator, you are moving clockwise. Okay. This one thing I forgot to tell yesterday. What else is remaining? Okay, that's what I wanted to tell you. So next, so we'll start with the first topic. As I told yesterday, strip lines, microstrip lines, design part we'll see later. First, we will be doing Smith charts, because you will at least get a 10 marks question. And in the last semester, last exam, they asked 2 10 marks questions on Smith chart only from the first module itself. So if you are very clear about Smith chart, you can score 20 marks there only. So next topic is single stub design. So first, what is stub? We know transmission lines. Stub is nothing but a section of transmission line. So transmission line, how we had modeled? We had modeled it like a R, L, G, C. Right? R, L, G, C. Equivalent circuit of a transmission line. So stub is nothing but what? It can be a, it is nothing but R, L, G and C. Right? So depending on our design, we can keep other values zero and we can just have it as an inductor, or we can just have it as a capacitor. What? A stub. Okay, so we want to design a single stub design. Why we require single stub design? Again, because we require ZL equal to Z naught. Usually that won't be the case. So we have to design some network such that ZL equal to becomes equal to Z naught. So that network is called as impedance matching network. So we have to design impedance matching networks. Okay, so first step to design an impedance matching network is single stub design. Second is double stub design. Next lecture we'll see example on single stub design, and next to that we'll see one more example on single stub design. Then we'll move to double stub design, and finally we'll have LC section match. So out of these three, at least bare minimum one question will be asked on these three designs. Okay. So how to proceed with single stub design? So I'll draw a normal circuit which we draw in transmission lines. So this is my load impedance ZL, this is my transmission line of length L, this is my generator voltage VG, and it is having, transmission line is having a characteristic impedance of Z0, right? While matching, we are not concerned about the source. Right, and I'll just replace the transmission line by a simple line. So I have this as ZL. ZL will be, let's say, R plus JX, the resistance plus reactance, and this will be Z naught. So single stub designing will be designing in Smith chart. Okay, and this is what ZL. I want to make ZL equal to Z naught. Let's assume it is not equal now. So I want to make ZL equal to Z naught. So what I'll do? I'll introduce a stub in parallel. Okay, so I have introduced a stub. What is this that I have drawn? This is a stub. And since it is only one stub I am adding, it is single stub. If I add two stubs, it is double stub. Okay, so it is at a distance L1 from the load, and the length of the stub is LS. Okay, so I want to make ZL equal to Z0. So for that, what I am doing, I am introducing a stub. So how does this help in matching? So since we will be designing in Smith chart, so we will normalize it. So Z0 normalized with Z0 will give me what? 1 plus J0. ZL will become ZL. This should be capital R plus JX. So now it will become small. But if you observe, it is connected in parallel, right? So in parallel, adding admittances is easier as compared to resistances or impedances, right? So I'll convert ZL to YL on the Smith chart. So this will become what? G plus JB. YL equal to G, YL bar equal to G plus JB. And my stub is over here. Okay. So I have to match. So I have to make G plus JB. This was what I wanted to make ZL equal to Z0. So now my problem is reduced to making G plus JB equal to 1 plus J0. So how to do that? Okay. So while understanding the concept, we'll move from left to right, but while plotting, we'll go from right to left. So for plot on Smith chart, we'll go from right to left. But to understand the concept, we'll start from 1 plus J0. So the first thing which you need to remember is the stub always changes the reactive part only. It is usually an inductor or a capacitor. It always changes the reactive part only. Okay. So what I want to do, I want to make 1 plus J0 equal to G plus JB. And I know stub is connected in parallel, it changes only the reactive part. So this section is what? 1 plus J0. So let's say this is point A, this is point B. So here I have, towards the left of the stub, I have 1 plus J0. Since stub changes only the reactive part. So let's say, so what I'll get here, something like 1 plus JB prime. I'll not use B since B is already here, right? So since stub has changed only the reactive part, resistance remains the same. Reactance has changed. So 1 plus J0 became 1 plus JB prime. Okay. So now this is what? A transmission line. So we have seen in transmission lines that as you move along the transmission line, impedance changes. Right. So here, let's say this is B minus. And this side is B plus. So B plus was what? 1 plus J0, B minus we got 1 plus JB prime. Okay. So 1 plus JB prime, I want to convert to G plus JB. So when I move towards the load, what is happening? I'm moving along the transmission line. So what will change? Resistance will change as well as reactance will change. So that is what I am getting. One is changing to G and B prime is changing to B. Fine. But now how to make 1 plus JB prime equal to 1 plus J0? We know stub changes only the reactive part. So if I have a stub with reactance minus JB prime, what will happen? 1 plus JB prime minus JB prime will give me what? 1 plus J0. So I have achieved matching. So what we are doing? So now how to plot on Smith chart? First we'll plot ZL bar. Right? Second, we'll draw the VSWR circle. Why we require a VSWR circle? Because while moving along the transmission line, impedance will change. So on the VSWR, always the impedance will change. Then what will we do? We'll plot YL bar. How will we plot YL bar? We have seen in transmission lines, we go 180 degree. We take the diametrically opposite point of ZL bar. So once we get YL bar, we have, this is YL bar. What we do? We move along the transmission line such that we get R equal to 1. That is, suppose this is my YL bar. Remember, I am saying YL bar. I'll have a VSWR circle, right? What I'll do, I'll move on the circle. And how am I moving? From YL bar, how am I moving? I am moving away from the load, that is towards the generator. So towards the generator means clockwise. So I'll go like this and I'll wait at where R becomes equal to 1. That is what I am trying to tell you. So from YL bar, I have YL bar now. From YL bar, I'll move along the VSWR circle such that I encounter R equal to 1. So at this R equal to 1, I'll encounter some reactance. Let's say it is 1.1. So what I've got, B prime is 1.1. So I've got 1 plus J 1.1. Right? So I've traveled some length. So that length is L1. So I can find that length L1 using Smith chart. So this length is L1. And what I know, I have a stub. So it should have a reactance of what? Exactly negative of JB prime. So this, since this was j 1.1, where is j minus j 1.1 over here, right? And let's say the stubs can be of two types, either short circuit or open circuit. Let's say this is a short circuit stub. So where is my short circuit? Over here. So consider short circuit as load. You want to come here. So again, you are moving away from the load. So where you will move? Towards generator. So we'll move like this. So this distance will be LS. This is how we achieve matching. So again, I'll repeat. First, we'll plot ZL bar. Then we'll plot VSWR circuit. Then, since the stub is connected in parallel, admittances will be easy. So we'll go to YL bar, diametrically opposite point of ZL bar. So we have YL bar. Then we want to make it 1 plus JB prime. So G is changing to 1, B is changing to B prime. Means we have to move on VSWR circle. So we'll move along VSWR circle such that G becomes R equal to 1. Right? So at R equal to 1, we'll encounter some reactance B prime. Now we know stub always changes the reactive part only. So plus JB prime will become minus JB prime. Right? Then, considering this is short circuit load, consider short circuit as a load always. So we are moving away from the load. So we'll go in the clockwise direction. So this distance is LS. Okay. So again, I'll tell this in a jiffy in the next lecture, and we'll actually design a single stub matching problem on Smith chart. Okay. Thank you.